Hello, and as always, thank you for watching us here at Palos Heights Community Channel 4. My name is Carol Steffen, on camera with Judy Weber. We've been invited in to the Plows Building Organization, located here in Palos Heights. We are so fortunate to have this outstanding business as a part of our, it's a social service business. Started like 1975 in Oak Lawn, I believe, through the Rotary. From what I sadly remember, but anyway, it's a growing social organization that caters mainly to the seniors, but there are exceptions to their caring also. I'm here with Executive Director Ken Grunke. Am I saying that correctly?
Correct.
Okay, and we've met a couple times. Anyway, talked one time before and had a. It's interesting. I have dozens of notes here because they do so many things. Honestly, Ken. First of all, tell me, you've been here for how long?
So, almost going on 2.5 years
Has
now.
It been
second executive director in 44 years.
Oh my God, well congratulations.
Yeah.
Hang on.
Yeah, right.
I don't even know where to begin. Let's start with the acronym PLOWS. What does PLOWS stand for?
So PLOWS stands for Palos Lamont Orland Worth Townships. So we serve the 20 communities within that respective area. We served last year 16,000, a little over 16,000 individuals. That is up from almost 1,000 from the year before, believe it or not. And we just have the one location here in Palos Heights. We have close to 70 staff members. Majority are full-time and we have some part-time. We're really the go-to premier leader in aging resources. So we're very proud of that.
And you should be.
Yeah.
Now, if someone has a problem, can they call you? Is there a phone number that they can reach you? Is it better for them to make an appointment before they come in? Or?
So there are certain programs that we ask if the individual could make an appointment. And okay. They can do that by calling our number at 708-361-0219. And a lot of our programs otherwise are just giving us a call and we'll respond accordingly. Some of those programs that do require an appointment are available also on our website at plows.org. Otherwise, they can call.
Tell me about some of the programs.
Yeah, so some of our programs include case management, which is really going out into the community, assessing an individual, in this case, obviously an older adult's environment.
And is there an age minimum or an age that you redo? Is it 60 and over? Is there a
So all of our programs in general respond to anybody navigating the aging life cycle.
Okay.
And so we do, though, of course, focus on those 60 years of age and older. And of course, there are some programs specifically focusing on those 18 years of age and older with a disability.
Okay.
So definitely there is a range of different programs. For example, the Grandparents Raising Grandchildren Support Group. We have, obviously, you're going to have the grandchildren that are a part of that. You might see some teens, some adolescents as well. Adult children identifying as a caregiver as well. And then there are specific programs with regards to our case management program, which is going out in the house. And it's really focusing on the older adult and looking at how they are navigating their environment. What kind of help or assistance do they need?
Okay. Is there a money needs base? Is there a minimum or maximum that you'll deal with as far as income?
So many of our programs are asset-based and many of them are income-based. And the best way to know that is to call, again, 708-361-0219 to find out more information about what those requirements are. It's important to note, too, that these programs, it's in a contract or an agreement with the federal government, with the state government. So these programs are not PLOWS designed.
Okay.
These are programs that were created by the government, and we are basically the messengers in carrying these out. So it does get very difficult when we do receive a call from somebody and they say, gosh, I really need this program, but they may not qualify.
Okay.
Based on the requirements of that particular program. But we definitely do try to find ways to support that individual as much as possible.
Okay. You have so many other things other than just servicing the community. You have volunteer opportunities. Let's touch on that.
Yes, we have a lot of volunteer opportunities. In fact, our volunteers are really the lifeline, I would say, to some degree and extent of PLOWS. We have probably over 110 volunteers.
Really?
The majority of those volunteers are through our home delivered meals program. So we require on the generosity of volunteers to come to the office here in the mornings, mm-hmm. package meals, and basically take them out and deliver them to clients who have mobility issues. Maybe there's some social isolation, you know. And at the same time, they're also providing a well-being check. So a lot of times, this individual, this volunteer, is really that individual's, that client's only connection. And so it's very, very important that these volunteers are in place. In fact, we definitely have a need always for backups as well, given that a volunteer goes on vacation or maybe is absent, et cetera. We also have volunteers in terms of our multidisciplinary group, which is an advisory group of individuals and experts around legal, maybe it's law enforcement, really helping to address certain and complicated cases in our Adult Protective Services department, which is really, of course, elder abuse. And so we require maybe somebody, a banker, in financial exploitation. So we definitely have those kinds of volunteer opportunities. And then we have in-house operational. So our newsletter, in terms of packaging that together, that requires an enormous amount of time. So we definitely ask the volunteers if they can help us with that. And there's also odds and ends, too, in terms of filing and some administrative kind of work as well.
Is there a training that you offer the volunteers? Is there something specific that they do if they're dealing with some of the things that you've mentioned?
Absolutely. Christine Sudreth, who's our community relations coordinator, does all the trainings for the volunteer. And depending upon the program that the volunteer is being matched with, there might be a different kind of training involved. But we make sure that that individual is not only trained appropriately and obviously with input from the staff members of that particular program, but a lot of times those volunteers are get to shadow as well. And so there's almost a mentoring kind of role as well to make sure that they feel comfortable.
How would one of our volunteers or one of our viewers find out more about it? I know you have a website. Want to give us the website?
Yes, it's plows, plows.org.
Okay.
You can also, so there's some opportunities there where you can click on for interest in volunteer as well as an email. But you can also call us at 708-361-0219.
Okay.
And our front desk staff will direct individuals accordingly, in this case to Christine.
Okay. If someone was interested in or had received some of your benefits and would like to donate and support you, how would you go about doing that?
So there's a couple ways to do that. One is to give us a call and we can provide information on best how to send that donation in. Obviously, they could stop by if they'd like to drop it off as well. But also go on to our website at, again, plows.org, and you can make an online donation that way as well.
There's other ways. How about donating like property or things that be of value for you?
Yes, if there's any kind of in-kind or something outside of maybe a typical financial contribution, it's always best to give us a call first because there's probably some sort of procedures that we want to make sure that we're following and advice that we're going to need to give accordingly depending upon that donation.
Do you have anybody that goes out into the community and talks to different groups and organizations and let them know that what you do and how valuable you can be?
Yes. So Christine Sudreth, again, really our community relations coordinator, spearheads that that area. She probably gets involved with around 25 to 30 different programs, presentations throughout the community. But what we've really been doing is involving some of the staff members themselves. And they really enjoy that because it's also a face of who potentially the community is going to be seeing. If they qualify and if they decide to apply for those particular programs and services. But it's also a great way to get some more detailed information. You know, there's so much information, as you pointed out earlier, about our programs and services. Sometimes it's really nice to have a program staff member available to be able to answer those specifics.
We're here on the first day of May. May has finally arrived.
Mm-hmm.
It's not raining.
It's a plus.
Do you have anything special? Did I read where May is a special for aging month?
Yes. So the Administration on Community Living has designated May as Older Americans Month. And so we're celebrating that. Their theme or their tagline is to connect, create, and contribute. And so we've designed a lot of programs in which folks can connect and almost create in some way. For example, we have a slew of caregiver support related programming going on, whether, and so many people identify as a caregiver these days, mm-hmm. and whether you're somebody that's a neighbor looking out for maybe another neighbor, maybe you're an individual that is an adult child that is trying to balance both your own children and an aging parent or loved one. At the end of the day, we all seem to find ourselves in a caregiver related mm-hmm. kind of position. So these caregiver support programs are really intended to peer-to-peer and also bring other caregivers together to let them know you're not alone and to let them know what resources are available to them. Some of them focus on particular areas like early stages of dementia or Alzheimer's, mm-hmm. which we're seeing a lot of. And some of them, as I mentioned earlier, are like grandparents raising grandchildren. We're really seeing an increase in terms of grandparents playing a critical role in the life of a child. And I'd like to think that maybe I'm a great example of that, because if it wasn't for my grandparents, I'm not sure if I would be here today. Mm. So it's very, very important. We also have an amazing program that we've been running annually with in partnership with the Center of Disability and Elder Law. And there's so many challenges around putting together a living will or power of attorney. And the great thing is that Center of Disability and Elder Law does this all for free. They bring all these folks together who signs up, so you do have to sign up. You can do that again by calling 708-361-0219 or going to plows.org. And what happens is they let all the attendees know what materials, what items they need. They bring them all back a month later and for free at no cost. Really? You can have a living will and a power of attorney. So that is an amazing, amazing, we usually max out in that particular program.
And is that held here or is that held?
That is held off-site, yeah, okay. Yes.
And how would someone find out where that's held? I know you mentioned the website, but is there either pamphlets available? Do you advertise in the newspaper? Or
yes.
How would it, so other than calling?
Yeah, absolutely. So we have been promoting out with our new marketing coordinator, okay. Jennifer Pedersen, and so we've really been trying to get the message and the word out, especially during Older Americans Month, because of the number of programs that we have available. So we hope that you will be reading and seeing that in the local papers, local channel, of course, cable television, and by word of mouth. We, you know, the more that we talk about what we do, the more it starts spreading.
It's just amazing. They've been in existence for 44 years. Mm-hmm. And all that you've accomplished in that short period of time, because 44 years isn't a lot.
Right.
When you think of everything that you've accomplished. What do you see the future bringing?
Finding a space that really can accommodate the work that we do. You know, we moved recently a part of our programs to the first floor. It was really an outcome of a strategic plan that we conducted a couple years ago. And the staff and the community both said it would be great, in particular for our home delivered meals drivers and also those that are accessing our advocacy and benefits program, which requires an appointment, if we could do this on the first floor. And sure enough, there was office space that was available on the first floor. We did a complete renovation and we're already maxing out of that space.
Really?
So it's really finding a space that we can grow into versus growing out of. That's what we really like to see.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
You've accomplished so much and you have yet so much to do, because the needs are great as the population is getting older and older and older.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Do you have pamphlets available if people aren't easy with the computer, comfortable with the pamphlets available at the library? Do they have things about... where do you put your information out?
Yeah, that's a great question. So we do make it a point to go to all of the spots that the majority of community members within that particular community might convene. So the libraries, the park districts or recreation centers, the village halls, the hospital even, that we put that information out there. And a lot of places that, you know, in terms of partners and community stakeholders, for example, some of our nonprofits that we partner with, they'll even house or have some of our information available as well. So we really try to find different ways to make sure that information is put out there.
Thank you so much for
letting us
come in and meet with you. And sometime we'll have to come out and have a tour of on Channel 4.
Absolutely.
And show some of the things in action.
Yes.
It's just,
that would be great.
It's such a prideful thing for you to be located here in Palos Heights. It's really a wonderful thing that we have at our beck and call. And if you're interested in volunteering, call. If you're interested in donating, call. If you're interested in just hearing more about the programs that are being offered here, call. There's no reason. You can drive in and go to the first floor and meet somebody.
Absolutely.
And ask. There's no reason not to get help. If you need help, there's no reason not to reach out to Plows. They're here. They offer wonderful, he said, this young man is a young delight, and the services are offered. Take advantage of them. And as always, thank you for taking advantage of Channel 4 being in your homes.